to rescue us, and as soon as he sends some help our way, we turn around and go back to our other ways. See, he was willing to accept him as Savior, but he wasn't ready to turn his life over to him. Here he is in the midst of this death row dialogue. The thief that is hanging on the right decides to cut across and interrupt before Jesus can even attempt to respond. The Bible says that the other thief rebuked him, saying, "Don't you fear God? Considering the situation that we are currently in, we are on death row, and now you're trying to make a deal. Don't you understand that this man did no wrong? Don't you understand that this man that's laying in, that's on the cross in here with us, he's not getting what he deserves, but we, sir, are getting exactly what we deserve. However, this man that hangs in between us, this man that is unjustly beside me, this man that I've seen only do good works has done no wrong." The thief then gets the opportunity of a lifetime. Not simply an opportunity to change his situation, but an opportunity to change his eternity. The thief says to Jesus, "Remember me when you come into your kingdom." He takes the time to acknowledge the lordship of Christ. And Jesus responds in a way that the only way Jesus can. Jesus tells him, "I tell you the truth." Let me pause parenthetically right there. It's something about that phrase, "I tell you the truth." Not that Jesus ever told a lie. So why would Jesus make emphasis on, "I tell you the truth"? Well, it's probably because what comes after, "I tell you the truth." Jesus says, "I tell you the truth, that today you shall be with me in paradise." That's perplexing to me.